When we write about this relations between Algeria and the European Union, everyone in Algeria wants to know what we can have with this about this relation, because the European Union is most important partner of Algeria, and we have an association mm-hmm. with Union European.
Okay, bilateral agreement.
Yes, since 2001, mm-hmm. and every people wait from. What will happen about this?
Are people understanding a lot about European Union?
Maybe many people understand because we have many relations with every countries of the United of the European Union, mm-hmm. like France, like Italy, yeah. like Spain, like. And many people want to know more about this this relation.
Alors, non, mais la difficulté, c'est de faire un peu un travail didactique. Il y a une machinerie très forte, très puissante pour la presse internationale ici et dans les institutions européennes, mais elle est d'abord consacrée effectivement aux journalistes européens eux-mêmes, ce qui se comprend. Et un peu de plus en plus, il y a des ouvertures, c'est pas encore parfait, mais des ouvertures pour les pays arabes en général et pour le Maghreb. On n'est pas une grande préoccupation pour l'Europe, aussi il n'y a pas beaucoup d'efforts en direction de cette catégorie de journalistes, mais enfin, les choses étant accessibles, nous, c'est un peu la petite difficulté, c'est de ne pas nous appesantir dans les détails du fonctionnement de l'Union européenne, qui est lourd, qui n'est pas explicite et qui n'intéresse pas vraiment le public de savoir comment on prend une décision, à quel moment il y a une co-décision. Mais en gros, c'est un peu les politiques européennes, méditerranéennes, arabes, africaines, maghrébines, et plus thématiques aussi, l'immigration. Ou l'immigration clandestine ou légale, puisque notre communauté aussi existe ici, maghrébine, et puis les questions sur l'énergie, terrorisme, etc., sont autant de sujets qui sont un peu communs ou qui sont d'intérêt pour vous aussi. C'est un peu d'ailleurs l'essentiel des sujets ou le plus gros des sujets qui intéressent notre public.
Donc, si j'ai bien compris, vous posez la question sur les rapports entre l'Algérie et l'Union européenne. Vous savez, en ce moment, entre l'Algérie et l'Union européenne, le hasard de la géographie font que l'Algérie et l'Union européenne, il y a juste la Méditerranée qui nous sépare. Mais ce qui fait que nous, ce qu'on attend en ce moment de l'Union méditerranéenne, c'est qu'elle aide l'Algérie à se développer. C'est-à-dire que nous avons beaucoup de potentialités en Algérie. Nous avons du pétrole, nous avons des compétences et tout ça. Nous, notre souhait, c'est que l'Union européenne nous aide à travers des programmes, à travers le transfert de la technologie, pour que l'Algérie puisse se mettre au niveau, parce que l'Algérie, c'est un pays qui a traversé, qui a connu un système socialiste. Donc là, nous sommes encore en transition politique et notre souhait, c'est que l'Union européenne intervienne plus à travers des programmes d'aide, à travers des programmes d'investissement, de façon à permettre à l'Algérie de finir avec cette phase de transition et passer à un système libéral.
Alors, ce qu'on fait, il est parfois difficile, effectivement, parce que la communication ne passe pas très bien entre les deux parties. Donc notre rôle, c'est de faire passer justement ce type d'information. On est en fait une passerelle, l'information est une passerelle, ou les journalistes sont une passerelle entre l'Union européenne et l'Algérie et la population algérienne. Mais je crois qu'il est encore... la population peut-être ne sait pas encore ce qui se passe réellement, mais ce type de formation déjà, si on est là, c'est aussi une manière de transposer ce contact entre les deux parties.
For the majority of Dominicans, the European Union is just a name of something afar, something that basically they don't know much about. The European Union does a lot of collaboration there, so most Dominicans know the European Union as this institution that goes and gives money, but to some causes. But they don't know like this whole structure behind of it, and they don't know this part of the structure that wants to have a relation other than just giving away money, other than just aid. But also trade, and among other things. So that's what we try to do. We try to convey a message that it isn't only just the plain news, but it's more explaining what the UN is, what the UN does, and if it's good or bad for us. It's not always good. So
the problem with the European Union is that they are one of the big donors in Senegal. You know, Senegal is a very poor country, so we have donors from Europe, from the United States and many countries. And for many times, Europe has been one of the main donors in Senegal, but they didn't publicize what they do. So the problem that is that the people don't know what they do. The moment the European Union came to the spot when they start negotiating the EPAs, I assume that you know what the EPAs are. But it was very negative from the perception the people had. So we had to try to balance, to show that probably everything is not very good from that side, but we don't have to forget what they have done before. So that's the exercise we have to do every time we write stories.
I think that we have to look at, first of all, the benefits. You know, what I learned here is that IPA is not such a bad thing as what we learn. As countries in a developing phase, as developing countries like Suriname and other Caribbean countries, there are many things that sectors like fishery, poultry, and so that has to be developed. And from what I learned is that if we don't do those things, no one will. The agreement is something free. You can sign it, but not for every sector. If I say, I want to liberalize the rice part, or I don't want you to bring out your chicken, or then it's something we have to respect. And that's why we are, as newspapers or journalists, we have to encourage the people or our community to do things, you know, because we cannot still keeping our hands up. There is a certain relation between developing countries like Suriname and the Netherlands because we are a colony, but we cannot keep asking money or let them give us the know-how to do things so that on a certain moment we have an equal relation, and that's what we have to do. That's our biggest challenge, I think.
I think the greatest challenge is that they feel so disconnected from the European Union. Because of where we're located, we identify a whole lot with the US of A, United States. And because of that, they seem to be attuned to the issues that are surrounding that area. So, you know, European Union is so far away, it's all the way across the Atlantic. So, you know, I think that's the biggest issue, trying to get them to connect, trying to explain to them and to break it down just how important these issues are to them and the benefits that it can bring to them as well. That's it right there.